Hello everybody, and today I thought I'd do something a little different and go over the differences between a single stage snowblower and a dual stage snowblower, and then we'll rip into it a little bit and look at things that you should be looking for if you're out buying one. And here we are, we're in the Moosehead Garage here. It's a very cozy place, a lot of fun happens here. When I'm not working on something. And what a crappy day it is really today. Let's take a look outside here. It's just ridiculously crappy. It's just wet, rainy, cold. So I figure we'll do some stuff inside today. So let me set up here and we'll get this thing going. Hey guys, so it's Halloween time and usually what I do is get my equipment ready for the winter time. It's going to be coming real soon. But I just wanted to explain the difference between a single stage snowblower and a dual stage snowblower. Maybe help you out on it. If you're shopping for one, what to look for, because you got to be careful out there. There's a lot of people selling junk, you know, they never took care of it. But I'm going to show you today how to take care of it. I'm going to show you how to pick one. Now this is a single stage, and the single stage, basically what it does, most of them have these, they're like rubber paddles here, okay? Now on the Toros, usually it comes, you get one paddle that you put on. This is made up of one, two, three, four paddles. And last year I repainted this. I'm going to be selling this unit because I've got this new one. This is a very good unit, very good in the snow. I just replaced this whole auger assembly here last year and these rubber pads. But one thing you want to look for on these is, and you can tell, you can see the scrape. Scraping from these paddles, these wear out. If your hand can fit behind these paddles, then it's no good. They're going to have to be replaced. So make sure you check that if you get one of these single stages. Now, why is it called a single stage? Because what it does is picks up the snow here. As this turns, the snow is fed up through and shot out through the chute. Now, the dual stage where these augers turn, and there's also an impeller inside. The impeller runs at engine speed and forces the snow out of the chute here. So it's a two-stage process. It is a lot more powerful, and it will shoot snow a lot farther than this one. So I guess it all depends on your area, that your requirements, space requirements. This right here is a compact 24 model that I picked up for $375. I had to do some things to it. Overall, it was in good shape. You can see it's in good shape here. Let's just set this down here. Now, the advantage to these is they're very lightweight. You can move them around. You can bring it up on your deck. You need to. It's not too heavy. Not too heavy. But you can bring that up and maneuver it. If you have a deck, a wooden deck, you can use it on that. This one here is also pretty maneuverable. Now, I've noticed they have these. This is a compact 24 Aarons model, and I've seen these at Home Depot. They have new ones, and they've really only changed maybe the engine. And they've put a spring here with an adjustment. You can adjust this from the bar, move this up and down. They really haven't changed much. The Tecumseh engine, you know, they don't make the Tecumseh engine anymore. So a lot of these units are coming with the Briggs & Stratton engine. But it's a great, you know, I can't wait to use it actually. The difference too, which you're going to see, I've got real tires here. with air in them. These here are just plastic tires. They work out well. You certainly don't have to worry about getting a flat tire with this. So now, with the snow blower, it's really tough. It really depends on your needs. This itself is a nice unit. This one is a nice unit also. Very easy to operate. You'll notice the difference between these chutes. This one you turn here, you'll turn it manually. This one has the knob you can turn. Now a lot of the newer ones have the knob here. It's a little easier, but this isn't a big deal. You're certainly not bending over as far as this. And when you're snow blowing, that's something you're going to have to constantly do when you turn around. Then you're going to have to turn it this way. Okay? Now, you can see the unit's very clean. I'm going to be selling this unit soon. You know, so if anyone's looking for a snow blower, I've been through this. The carburetor has been cleaned. The oil's been changed. Spark plug has been changed. When I get into units, I get into it bolt by bolt. Everything is very detailed. I get into it. So I just want to make sure it's good. So what are the kind of things that you look for when you're out buying a snow blower? Well, a lot of times they're going to tell you that they change the oil. In this particular case, the bottom of the dipstick was black on here. Can't really see it because it's clean now. I've already been through this machine. But the previous owner said that the oil was changed. I found out later when I had drained it, it was black. Alright? I could show you that oil. I'll be right back. Okay guys, we're back and I just wanted to show you how you can see that oil here. Kinda hard to see, but it's black. Okay, that was the oil that I removed. It's the oil I removed from this machine, so you really have to be careful. Owner of the machine tells you that the oil's been changed, I wouldn't trust it. I would check it yourself. So if you buy one of these machines, you know, aside from the fact of making sure it starts when you're looking at it, and checking obvious things like the condition of the cables, you know, check the wheels and make sure they're in good shape. There's a belt inside of this housing that comes off that controls the auger. Check that. Make sure that this isn't seized up and turns. Make sure this turns freely. And that it's not too rusty inside of there. And make sure it starts up. Obviously it comes with the key. You're going to need that to start it. The condition of the handles. Buying one and it's online, maybe on the Facebook Marketplace, or and it's all dirty and they show it all dirty, I wouldn't even go with it because they didn't take care of it. They didn't even take the time to clean it up, which can get you more money actually if you clean it up. But that tells me right there that's a red flag, so I kind of stay away from that. There's plenty of them out there. Like I said, this one will be for sale soon. It's like brand new. You just have to do some minor things to it. So, what do you look for when you're buying it? That is one of these units. Well, let's move this oil out of the way. What you're going to want to look for is make sure the tires have a lot of good tread on them. Now this model here is a 2005, which is amazing condition. And I've seen these units for $899 at Home Depot. Like I said, they only changed a couple small things. You know, these Tecumseh motors, they come in, these are workhorses. I've already been through the carburetor on this. Like I said, when I get them, I don't trust them. You know, what people say. So I went through and I basically pretty much disassembled the motor. Take a look inside of there. You know, same thing with these. You want to make sure that this moves freely. This comes with this little shovel, which is to clean out. Obviously, when the machine isn't running, you clean out the snow that gets packed in there. These machines don't really have that many problems with the specific machine with, you know, packed snow all the time. You know, you're going to get more of a packed snow issue with a single stage unit because you don't have the impeller. You know, you don't have the 2-second stage to help push the snow out to shoot. So, you want to check also. Want to check the augers here. Make sure there's nothing inside the augers when you're checking these out. Make sure it's free of any debris and whatnot. That's what I'm talking about, folks. You really got to check it out. Make sure there's nothing in here. Make sure it's clean. You know, if this is stored in the garage, sometimes you're going to get rodent nests inside of these. So you want to take a good look and clean it up. Now, you want to make sure that these augers are in good shape, that there's not too much rust on them. You know, what you can do, if it's in decent shape, is take some bar and chain oil. You know, you can take a cloth and just pour the bar and chain oil on it and wipe down. Just wipe down these augers here. That'll help. Waterproof them. If you notice, whenever you buy something like rotors for a car, they always have that oil and thin oil on them. Of course, inevitably you can't keep the oil on them, so you have to clean them off with a brake cleaner, and then they start to rust. So oil is a great preserver of metal. Wherever you can, try to lubricate everything here. You want to lubricate the chute where it turns. Put a little grease in there, you don't want to get crazy. On these units, it's a little tight in here, I got a bunch of stuff here. On these units here, you want to make sure that everything moves freely. Obviously that it starts, the tires are in good shape. This body here on these Ahrens are just unbeatable. They're so strong and so solid. I've seen units from, you know, 1960 online that are still using them. I think my neighbor has a, his is older, and it's a very reliable machine, so that's why I went with this Ahrens model. And for a used model for 2005, it's this incredible shape. You know, the condition of these shoes, which is the distance from the ground that you'll be picking up snow, check them out, what's the condition of them. Obviously, anything obvious like oil leaks down by the motor, any of these oil caps. If they can, remove this cover for you. So you can check the belts. The belts are underneath here. One's for the drive, and one's going to be for the auger. You want to make sure. Turn it around. You want to make sure if it does have an electric start, that the electric starter works and that it sounds good. You know, if you're getting a weird noise from it, you know, it might be on its way out. Make sure there's no gas leaking and the fuel lines look good. There's no cracks in them. How do the gears work? Does the drive mechanism work? The wheels turn properly? You can do a test by starting it up, which I won't do in here. Putting it in drive and holding it back. And watch the wheel should spin. These use a friction disc. friction disc technology, which is basically a disc with some rubber on it, kind of like a tire. And then there's a spinning plate below that. What this now does is move that friction disc to the left and to the right, depending on where it lands. So hence, really determines your speed. So make sure that this is free. Don't worry too much about it. There's a little bit of rust or it needs some lubrication. That's easy to do. So make sure the starter works. Make sure the recoil works. Okay, a lot of people use the electric start. It's more of a convenience than anything. And you can take this off, which I'm going to get to in another video. We can tear it down. I'd like to see what the engine looks like or how the starter works. You want to make sure that you clean the gas out when you get one as well. Always make sure you start with some good gas. And I've heard a recommendation that Delta Sonic sells ethanol-free gas, which you should really use. Most of these machines have a tolerance of 10% ethanol, I think it is. But you can always use a fuel stabilizer. Pour it in the tank there when you fill it up. But it is a good idea. And what I do is, most of these are going to have a fuel shutoff valve. I'll turn the shutoff, I'll have it running, and I'll turn the shutoff valve off and let the fuel run out. Now, it's not going to run it totally out, because down below your carburetor, you can have a bowl. And the bowl is still going to have some gas in it. You can remove the screw and take the gas out of the bowl, and some of them have a spring with a screw. You just push, and the gas will out of it. It's kind of like a drain plug. Your oil, make sure you change that. So overall, I hope I've helped a little bit in helping you decide on what kind of snowblower that you'd like to get. We'll be back another time to rip into this motor and we'll show you how to look for more things and how to repair this motor. Have a good day.